Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we are going to see how to install QDNN, the NVIDIA library to work with your GPU and also to create deep learning or machine learning applications in C++. We are going to start in how to install the library itself in your operating system, the steps that you need to fulfill to have the environment created, which is obviously fully depending on operating system and the conditions or the requirements that you have in your computer, the CUDA toolkit, the GPU you had, etc., etc. And secondly, we will follow a couple of examples just to show you how to create a small application which access to the GPU, compile it, link it, and execute it. In my case, I'm working in a Windows system Linux with CUDA Toolkit 12.3, and we will see how to create this. In the Windows system Linux, I have an Ubuntu 22.04, sorry. And where we will see how to do it in that environment, and I will give you a guidance how to you can prepare your environment or to replicate what you are gonna do. The first thing that you need to do is first of all verify if you had the CUDA toolkit installed. If you are working in a Windows system Linux, you will have probably installed already the CUDA toolkit, and it fully depends on the NVIDIA or the GPU drivers or the graphics driver that you have installed in your computer. In any case, we will install the CUDA toolkit in the Linux distro, because we need also some headers and some of the components on the CUDA toolkit that later on we will need to use it once we develop a code in our environment. So you probably, if you execute NVIDIA SME, you will get access to your GPU. And you can here verify if your Windows system Linux, like it's in my case, is Windows system Linux version 2. This is an Ubuntu distribution. And then once you have your driver installed it properly, you have access to the GPU directly once you install it. And then the idea is now create all the development environment to you be able to develop code and compile it, link it, and execute it in your environment. So the first thing that is just to check this is not you will need to install if you are working in a Linux box in the cloud or in a on-premises. First of all, you need to have the hardware, obviously the GPU. You need to install it, install the driver in the computer. If you are working on the cloud, follow the procedures for the specific cloud. They are completely different for the ones that you are gonna see here, or you are gonna see, or you have to follow if you are installing the NVIDIA in a Linux box, in a conventional Linux box. Usually, and I can speak about my experience with Azure boxes, Azure VMs or Amazon VMs. They had their specific procedures. For example, in Azure, you had to go to the Azure Marketplace, and once you had the VM installed and apply the configuration to install the CUDA toolkit for that, and then the most of the cases, and this apply to the three main cloud providers, the VMs that you had in there They are obviously kind of the derivants of the Ubuntu, CentOS, or other Linux variants, but they are how to say modified to work on cloud and to be deployed with some of specific characteristics of the provider. And then in that case, if you need some specific guidance in how to do this in Azure, in Amazon, even in Google, I can take a look. I didn't do it on Google so far, but I did it in Amazon and in Azure, installed the GPUs, the CUDA toolkit and so on, and all this stuff. If you need some support on that, let me know and I will do a guidance or even create a video for. So the first thing is install the driver, the NVIDIA toolkit. Here I'm going to give you the pages, where you can find the information. So the first thing is going to this page. I will give you later on all these links or steps. So to install it in a Windows or System Linux and or doing in Ubuntu is practically the same. The most important is just apply or install the correct CUDA keyring. So it fully depends on the distribution and the architecture you want to install. Obviously, it's not the same to install in Windows than in Mac or in whatever. Here for my Ubuntu, as you can see here, is a 2204 architecture x8064. So you have to get this keyring and then uninstall it, as you can see here. Please follow the instructions in this page and follow your architecture and the exact version, because this is going to drive the whole installation process. Okay, once you have this installed, we just apply the sudo apt getupdate and then uninstall the CUDA toolkit, and then on this will install the correct one depending on what you had in your in my case, as I have Windows or System Linux, it will install the adequate to the CUDA toolkit or to the driver I had installed it in Windows. If you are installed it in a pure Linux box, it will start the latest one available in the repository of NVIDIA. Here you can install as well the GDS packages and after that reboot. This is purely for Ubuntu. Follow the instructions. Here you had all the operating systems that you have, for example, Amazon Linux. As I mentioned you before, every system is had a slightly different. Amazon, for example, is a specific box developed by Amazon. It's something like a CentOS Linux, but has some differences. So again, please follow the instructions and fulfill the all these steps according to your installation. So once we have this done, the next step is install the QDNN, CUDA Deep Network Library. I give you as well the all the steps here on my on this TXT file. Later I will push all of this with the in the repository, and then you need to complete this, and then if you install the CUDA, you all this step you have been done, because this is essentially downloading the ring to point to the right repository. And once if you did it, if you install the CUDA toolkit, as is a prerequisite to install the QDNN library, and then on you don't need to do this. Okay? So next is do another update and install the QDNN 9. In my case, it has a CUDA toolkit 12.3 or 12.3, so I had to install this one. If you still had a CUDA toolkit 11, install this other version. Once you have this installed, I can give you some. You can go here and execute NCVB. This is NVIDIA CUDA. CUDA compiler. You just execute help or version, and then you can get essentially what is already installed. This is a C++ compiler that specifically NVIDIA designed to compile and to build applications to run in the GPU. You also can take a look to the to your GPU code or the code your SM. This is the GPU codes of the what that are compatible with my GPU. Don't forget, I had a NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1650, and then my library is compatible with all these NVIDIA cards codes. No? And the second one is the architecture of the GPU. You can also verify that. And I show you this because you later on will need it. No? GPU architecture, my GPU and my CUDA toolkit are compatible with all this architecture. So keep in mind that, because later on when you build the code and you link the code, you will need to specify under which architecture or GPU class you want to compile the code. Okay, so now we have this. This is I prepare some examples which later on I will show you I will post them in the repository. The first one is this small CPP code, C++. It's just accessing to the GPU, placing an array there, and executing kind of the same that you will do with a neural network. Nothing more. And then once we place the array, we just do some calculations with kind like apply a sigmoid, that dimension function, and that's it. No, it's just an example. It's nothing real, nothing that you probably will do on a real application. It's just to introduce you how you will do. So obviously here I'm writing in C++. I include the libraries you see here, the runtime and QDNN, and then on here I'm using some structures that are defining the library, methods as well. Methods not here, that data types. Here I'm using, for example, methods or classes that are in the QDNN or the CUDA runtime. So once you have the code done, just you can use that example. You can use in this case C++. To compile the code, and then here you can see here down I use the G++ compiler. Here with hyper I in upper letter I include the libraries I want to use to compile this software, and I'm using the US local CUDA include and US local CUDA targets is ATS64 Linux. Very important, really very important, always include the targets for your architecture and operating system. So if you include here Windows libraries, this is not gonna work, definitely. So include the right ones, and also when you are, this is basically when you are installing, you are including your operating system, but later also when you are compiling the code, you need to include the correct libraries. It's not, again, this is not gonna work. Hyper O, this is the output, is a .o file, and the input is the this CPP, which is my file. So you just execute the code, and then this is producing a .o file. Take it out, it's at 608, this is the time. And now if you want to link the code, we use the NVCC linker compiler. And then you can use something like this. We are using the NVCC, NVIDIA CUDA compiler. The taste that we use of our compiler is C++, the one that we use here. GenCode an architecture, you have it here. Remember what I showed you before. The output is going to be HB. The input is test.o. And include as well some of the libraries. Again, very important to use the right architecture. And also for the linker, use the QDNN and STDC++ link. You executed, and this had created an HB. HWU, and then now you can execute it. It's a binary file, and then you can see here we found a GPU. This is the architecture, the capability that we had in my GPU. We create a handler to work. We move this array. We later we do some calculations, as you can see on the code. Then we destroy it and we clean the GPU. It's not simple. For me, that I'm a Python developer, this is, well, I had some skills. I understand C++ and C or C sharp, but it's not the language that I use on my daily basis. So it's, it's far away, more complicated than to take a code in Python and understand it, execute it, even refactor or modify it to the purpose I want. But it's just an start. From what I see in the next years, many things are going to be moved to in this direction, especially C#, which is one of the language supported already in Google Cloud and in Azure, for sure. Azure, Microsoft is pointing in that direction, definitely. The reason as well to do this video is because recently I create some videos about quantization with ONNX runtime, and the idea of Microsoft creating this library is just compile or fine-tune the your modeling in Python and then on execute in any language. One of the favorites for Microsoft, obviously, is C#, which they are investing a lot of effort to make all the services as they have in Azure Cloud to be compatible and to run as well C# code. Why? Because obviously it's faster than Python. Python is not we can use some libraries to make it faster, like FunTools or Numba or many others, but at the end of the day, it's very difficult to compile with a compiled language in terms of the speed and also memory management and many other things that Python is weak in all these cases. So secondly, we are going to see one of these examples. Let me show you as well where I'm coming from. I will patch you this repository. It's from NVIDIA. Also this one. This one is in Python. Also, you to start with some of the once you had the QDNN and the CUDA toolkit, you can install as well this library. Follow the instructions as well how to fulfill this, but essentially once you have the CUDA toolkit, you can install the Python CUDA toolkit and follow this. This code had bindings with the C++ libraries of CUDA, QDNN. So well, this is just an example. We are going to check now here. This is just a tutorial that NVIDIA provide to develop in QDNN, it's done in Visual C++. So you have multiple examples, it's pretty extensive. So you will spend time in doing that. I will patch you later on that. We have samples introducing. I just took this, which is just creating a scalar product in floating 32 and also in floating 16 and do a comparison. So let's go here to the samples 0 introduction FP 16. And then on we have here, I'm going to remove the things I created before when I record this in Spanish. And I will remove also the output. Okay, and now once we have here, let's take a look. You have here this Q, that CU is another, well, to be honest, all this stuff here that you have here from the SLM to the VCX Pro is for Visual Studio. It's the project itself, blah, blah, blah. Yes, you don't need to care about that because it's just I'm working in VS Code. This is not working here. And then we have the makefile. The makefile is like a script which guides the compiler. So it's creating of the environment, putting all the directives from the compiler, the same that we did before with the C++ via a command line. You can just write it in a script with the name makefile and using the make. Also, to the make, you can provide some arguments. Here we are going to compile this file, this input file, FS16 scalar product.cu for the architecture existing 64. Here, believe me, there is you can take a look. There is a lot of arguments that you can use. The host, the architecture, target architecture, host architecture. Yeah, it's just a guidance or a set of instructions that will drive the compilation of the code depending on the architecture you have, the host compiler, the everything. So it's the libraries you have, you want to dynamic, you want static, many things. For those that are familiar with the compiling, are working on C or C++ or C#, you know exactly what I'm telling you. It's not, well, let's start, or you need to start reading some of the documentation. Very important, as you can see here, architecture, different architecture have different requirements. So here we are working at very low level in comparison with Python. Python is a high-level language with very high-level commands, which under the hood is doing many things. Many of them are connecting with the C libraries. And then what we do with the makefile is just driving the compilation. So you can see here, we are going to create the own file here. So here, essentially, we just create this file, FP product 16. The input was FS16 scalar product. You don't say anything. You just produce the same file, but ending in O. And once you have it, this is the compiled. This is a binary. You cannot read it. Well, you can read it, but you are not going to see anything because it's a binary file. You see here, open anyway, whatever, text editor. You see here is a binary. You will not understand anything. And now we will link it again with the NVIDIA CUDA compiler. And then it's very similar, the command, that the one that we use. Core, MVCC, Flavor G++, Architecture N64, Sain Architecture and Code, the output is going to be FP16, this is the input, and again we had the include libraries, CUDA targets, existing 64 in Linux, CUDA lib, 64, blah, 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 and the linked libraries as well. You just created, and this have created a FP16, look at the time that now we have, and you can now execute it. And again here we have a Turing model in my GPU, compatibility 7.5, and here the output in 32, 16, and they are comparing in this case the different, if there is a different about the threshold. If you can see here the result of the intrinsic, absolute, minus native is minus of this, means that the output is passive. For those that, you can see here, it's really similar to Python. Here we don't have the, how to say, tabs. You don't need to care about that. You need to enclose everything in brackets. But, well, it's for a developer, with the experimented developer, is my guess is not gonna take more than 2 weeks to be more or less not fluent, but to build an application is I was developing this many years ago. Obviously many things changes from that, and but the most that it change is not essentially the how you make the blocks. Is the compilers, the number of libraries that are available, etc., etc. And well, that's all. Essentially, it's, just I wanted to introduce you this topic because we are on this direction. We want to, or I want to do some tests with the ONX in C++ or CSAP, and see how to build applications in this code. Just I want to have the all my environment had to see set up to start to build not to build very complex applications. I want to fine tune and the models in Python, but later on be able to use it in a compiled language like C# or C++, and at least had this possibility. And also, show you to all of you and share our experience with you. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for watching the video up to the end. And as I used to say, give me a like if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. And share with your colleagues and friends just to help me to grow on YouTube with my channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye.